All right, everybody, this morning in the Music Beat, it is a new year, and that means new music. And here to fill us in on all of the new albums that are coming out and the latest news in the music world is Deanna Cruz from Hot 106.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hi.
Happy New Year. I know we're a couple of weeks in, but Happy New Year to you. Let's go over new music this month.
Very slow start to 2014.
I was going to say, just a few. Yeah.
Yeah. We have Bruce Springsteen coming out with his album today, actually, and Jennifer Nettles from Sugarland, her debut solo album. So those are kind of like the two albums you kind of want to get your hands on.
A lot of Bruce Springsteen fans out there, if they love it, they can get that. A lot of Sugarland fans, they can get that too. All right, music news. I saw this yesterday. This is just crazy. I don't know what's going on with this kid.
Yeah.
He's getting worse and worse as the day goes on. Justin Bieber, in trouble again for, doesn't he have anything else better to do?
No.
Egging neighbors' homes.
It's a Thursday night. I mean, he did this last week, apparently, and decides to egg his neighbor's house. They had been in a couple arguments before.
Right.
So, I mean, I could see that happening, but the neighbor heard someone throwing something at his door, you know, so he goes, and apparently there's some video where it sounds like Justin Bieber, but, you know, you can't really see anything because it's the dark, right? But apparently the neighbor went to see, you know, how much the damage is. It's over about $20,000. So Justin Bieber could be charged with a felony.
Because it's over a certain limit.
Exactly. Right.
Okay, next up. Drama in pop star Kesha's life. She entered rehab, and now mom's going into rehab.
So Kesha entered rehab because of her whole weight, and they're blaming it kind of on her producer, saying Dr. Luke. So she's got some problems there. But now her mom's been speaking up a lot, and I've been kind of like, why is her mom talking so much about this? So now her mom is entering rehab for post-traumatic stress, which I think is a good thing.
Okay.
So put mom away and kind of keep her quiet is what I say.
And you know, for her, she's not someone, she's had a ton of hits.
Yep.
She's not someone, though, that's usually in trouble, not someone you hear about doing drugs or anything else.
Right.
She's usually on the low key, so hopefully she can get it together.
Yeah, I hope so.
This was a big video last week. Jay-Z, he's coming to Boston. Coming up soon, this weekend actually.
Yep.
And there
I'm
was
going.
Video. You have one. And there was video last week of he was performing and he brought this little 12-year-old kid up to rap.
Yep.
So everybody's wondering if when he shows up in Boston, if he may do the same thing.
Right. So he was in North Carolina. It was a couple weeks ago. He brought this 12-year-old kid, and then last weekend he was in Chicago.
And the kid was great when he got up to.
Yeah.
It wasn't just like some kid who they just dragged up. This kid could actually sing and could actually rap.
Yeah. And then he brought up this 19-year-old girl in Chicago this past weekend. So Jay-Z's actually going to be at Mohegan Sun on Friday and then Saturday in Boston. So I don't know. I was thinking maybe I should have a sign saying, like, I can rap, but I can't.
Right.
So it'd be kind of embarrassing, but apparently it seems to be working. If you're in the front row, put up a sign, and next thing you know, you may get on stage. But if I were you, I'd make sure I know how to rap.
You know, I was reading a lot of people were saying they thought that maybe this is some sort of publicity stunt. They think that this is some way that he's bringing out new artists and trying to develop new artists. What do you think about that?
I don't think so. This girl, the one in Chicago, apparently one of his producers or something asked for her number, so maybe they'll follow up with that. The other kid, he's 12 years old, so I think he's kind of waiting on him, but there was no phone numbers exchanged or anything like that. But I hope it happens.
Yeah, hopefully it happens. It's a great way, if they are finding people, it's a great story that these people will have.
Like, how were you discovered? Right. I went to a Jay-Z show and I held up a sign.
And got up on stage.
Exactly.
And I know when he was really impressed by how well the little guy did when he got up there. So hopefully something happens for them. One more thing. Back to the two CDs being released.
Sure.
Bruce Springsteen, Jennifer Nettles. Any idea why she's flying solo on this?
I don't know.
Because, I mean, they're a popular group. I mean, it's not like people don't love them.
More money for her?
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Why not?
Yeah. And the boss is back, I guess, if you're into Bruce Springsteen.
Yeah.
Me, not so much.
No?
No, yeah. I don't know.
I think we've had this discussion before.
Yeah, we have. Yeah. I've probably said it more than once. All right, thanks for coming in. If you want to learn more about anything Deanna just covered, we are going to post it on our website. Just go to WPRI.com and click on The Road Show.